was thinking about mine, and it was probably something to do with cockroaches. I don't like cockroaches, guys. I've had some scarier things than cockroaches, but that was the first one that came to mind when I was preparing my message. Pray for me. All right. But no, seriously, if what you fear the most typically reveals what you value the most. So my question is that, what do you value? What is your value? Because the fear is always something that you're scared that could be hurt, could be harmed, and whether it's your life, your relationship, or your whatever the case may be, that's what you value. Because whatever you're afraid to lose, that's what you fear. That's what you value. And God's saying, that's what I want, that right there. Because that's what I want to use. And you can't go all the way what God has if you're still holding back and you're saying, and you're walking around and operating in fear. What if? God, what if it costs me something? What if going on with you, what if it costs me a relationship? What if it costs me to be rejected from all my friends? What if it costs me for people to talk about me and ridicule me? What if it costs me to look like I'm crazy because I'm trusting you and people don't understand? What if? Romans 3:3 said, and it'll talk about this. Paul was having a conversation, I believe this was with the Jews and the Gentiles. He says that, what if some were unfaithful? Will their unfaithfulness nullify God's faithfulness? Not at all. To let God be true and every human be a liar. Let God be true and every man a liar. See, many times we talk about this scripture. When we have opposition in our life, we say, oh no, let God be true. Let every man be a liar. But I'm going to tell you today, what if you're the liar?
Amen. Amen.
What if you're the liar?
Teach that.
Every time that we say something contrary to the word of God, something that doesn't line up to the promises, this scripture's talking to you.
Amen.
It's talking to me. Anytime I don't do what I'm supposed to be doing, when I'm walking in doubt and unbelief, it's talking to me.
Yeah.
Let God be true, let every man be a liar. And so if my life and my conversation is not lining up to what God says, and I'm the liar that he's referencing in this scripture, I'll own it if you don't want to own it. I know sometimes people are like, this is not one of them churches where you get that feel-good word. It's that word that you give you that goes straight to your core. God is faithful. Said, let him be true.
Yeah.
Every man else be a liar. That's why we have to seek God. I want to seek God so I'm not a liar. So that when I say, oh, God is good, all the time, God is good, you're a liar. Because you don't believe me. That's why it's important to understand what the word of God says. I did not give you the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. So if you're walking around in fear, you say, I know I'm blessed, I'm highly favored, you're a liar.
Amen. Good.
Well,
I'm going to another topic.